Hi everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how to find the largest digit of a number in C++. So let's get started. So for this we'll be using four important steps with the help of a while loop. So let me just first list down the four steps. So first thing is we'll be getting a number n from the user, or you can hard code it. And here we'll be using a while loop with a condition while a particular number is greater than zero, okay? And the next thing is that we will basically iterate through each and every single digit of a number. So let's suppose say that we are having a number as n equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. What we will do is, in the first iteration, that is the first iteration of the while loop, we will separate the last digit from this number. Alright? So we will be basically storing this particular last digit. Let me have a variable for that as r. We will store the last digit in this variable r. So r will be basically 4. And how we will do this, that r equal to n modulus of 10. So basically, if you find the modulus of any number, we will be getting the remainder or the last digit. So let's suppose say that we have a number 123. Modulus of 123, we give the last digit, which is 3. So whatever may be the number, by doing modulus of 10, we will be getting the last digit. So here you can see we have got the last digit. And in the next step, what we will do is, we will initialize a variable max, okay? And this max value will be initialized to 0. Because the smallest value that a number can have is 0. Basically, we have digits from 0 to 9. So 0 is going to be the smallest value. So it's always good to assign max to 0. And what we will do is, we will just have a simple if condition. If our r is greater than max, what we will do is max equal to r. You will just assign this r's value to our max, because this maximum variable will have the largest digit of our number. So as we iterate to each and every digit of the number, if that particular r, like in the next iteration, our r is going to be 3, and we will do the exact same thing. And if that r is greater than max, we will assign r's value to max again. So let's suppose that I have 9 over here, and this time max value is 3. Now during this iteration, max value is 3. It comes here, next value is going to be 2. Nothing happens because 2 greater than 3 is false. Nothing happens. Next iteration, r becomes 9. And what happens here is that 9 greater than max, 9 greater than 3, which is true. And we need to assign that, and max becomes 9. So basically, we will be having this max variable to get the largest digit. And finally, you may ask me, like, because here we are having like 1, 2, 3, 4. How will we like traverse through each and every digit? Because as I told you earlier, by doing modulus of 10, we can extract the last digit alone. So you may ask me how we will be able to like access 1, 2 and 3. So for this, what we will do is, we will basically eliminate the last digit after this if condition. So what we will do is, n equal to n slash 10. Basically, this will eliminate the last digit. So this won't eliminate the last digit. This will just fetch us the last digit, but the number will remain the same. You get the point, right? Even though if you take 4 from this digit, by doing modulus, the number n will still remain as 1, 2, 3, 4. But what will happen here is that if I do 1, 2, 3, 4 slash 10, the quotient is going to be 123. Alright, here we are not giving the remainder. This is plain quotient. Okay, so if we have like 55 slash 10, the quotient is 5. Alright, it is not remainder, it is the quotient over here. So, and we are just assigning this particular number to our number variable itself. So basically, we are overwriting 1, 2, 3, 4 by 1, 2, 3. And by this way, we are eliminating the last digit. And that's it basically. If you just repeat this process, at the end, what will happen is that our n will become 12, 1. And at the end, our n value will become 0. And this while loop condition will terminate. And we'll be getting the max stored in our variable. So enough of commenting out pseudo codes. Now let me just go into the main code, right? So we are having a number. We need int n. And also we need a max variable, int max equal to 0. So it's always better to have, you know, this point so that we can like easily code throughout it. And if we just have a cout saying enter number, next thing is going to be cn number, and next thing is going to be while number greater than 0. So this program is exactly similar to sum of digits of a number, reversing a number. So there are more common programs by this way. Only this if condition like makes it unique. And next thing is, we need to also have a variable r, to store the remainder or the last digit, this one. And what we did here, r equal to the number modulus of 10. So modulus of 10. And next thing, we had a if condition. So it's going to be if r greater than max. Be careful, it is not max greater than r. We are just checking if the digit is greater than our max variable. And what we are doing is, we are assigning r's value to max. Next digit, we are just eliminating the last thing. The next step, n equal to n slash 10. Just, we are just removing the last digit. So this is pretty much it. And after that, c out, we'll just have the largest digit max. We'll just print the variable max. Okay. So this is basically the code, guys. These are comments. You don't need to type this out. Okay. Saving it. And if I execute and run it, compile and run. Just zoom it. So I will go with 1, 2, 3, 2, 6, 0. So I need to get the output as 6. I'm getting max as 6. I'm getting max as 6. And next thing, I will go with some other value. Alright, so what value can I give now? Let me just go with something called as 6, 5, 4, 9, 1, 2, something. I'm getting max as 9. And in case, let's see what happens if we put a negative number. So I have never tried this out. So let me just now just run it. So what if I do a negative number? So let me just go with -9, 1, 2, 5, 6. Alright. So neglecting the minus sign, we need to get 9 as the output, but I don't know what we are going to get. Okay, I'm getting 0 in the output. So let me just now go to the code and explain you why we are getting 0. So here we are having a while condition as n greater than 0, right? But here we have specified a negative number. So basically, this condition just fails over here because minus, it's going to be obviously lesser than 0, and this while condition fails instantly. So our code is not even going inside this, and we are directly printing max because initially our max value is 0. So let's suppose that I will put max value as 100, some random 100. So if I now run this and put a negative value, I'll be getting max equal to 100 because this particular operation doesn't even occur. So let me just go with max minus 1, 2, 3. I'm getting max 100. So basically, this number is just getting printed because nothing happens here. So what you can do is, you can just have a simple if condition check. Okay, after c in n, if number is less than 0, what you can do is number equal to n asterisk minus 1. So basically, we are just converting our negative number into a positive number because minus into minus is going to give us plus. So we are just converting a negative number into positive number over here. So this is a simple fix you can do. So let me just try running this one also. Yeah, so if I go with normal number 1, 2, 5, 4, 9, getting 9, it's fine. And if I go with a negative number this time, -7, 6, 5, 3, 1, I'm getting 7 in the output. So this basically works. So that's the program, guys, and I hope you would have found this video useful. Do check the playlist of my channel. I've done many programming tutorials in C, C++, Java, Python, Node.js, React.js, MongoDB, Spring Boot, Grid Operations, as well as Blender and Figma. So check them, subscribe me. Thanks for watching.